So in this section, we're going to talk a little bit about subtracting whole numbers. And to just show some of the ideas that we're going to be talking about, let's just start off with an example. Say that you have a total of $8, and somebody wants to borrow $3 from you. Well, most of us can do this by hand, by just looking at it. If we have $8 and somebody borrows $3 from us, we're still going to have $5 left. So the ideas that we're expressing here are the ideas of subtraction. The $5 is called the difference. So whenever you're asked to find the difference between two numbers, you're essentially being asked to subtract. And then the $8, that's called the minuend. And the minuend is the number you're subtracting from. So I have $8, so that's what I'm subtracting the $3 from. Finally, the 3 is called the subtrahend. And in subtraction, it really does matter which is the minuend and which is the subtrahend, because it will make your difference come out to a different number if you flip them around. So one of the ways that we can check that we did this right is if we take the $5 that you have left, and you add to that the $3 you let someone borrow, you would have the $8 back again. So one of the ideas that we're going to talk about is that you can check subtraction by adding. You can check if you did a subtraction right by adding. Essentially, we're going backwards. Okay? So keeping that in mind, we can go ahead and do some of these problems ourselves. So we can go ahead and subtract. So if I want to subtract 9 from 12, 12 would be my minuend, and 9 would be my subtrahend. So if I subtract 9 from 12, I would get 3. And I can check this is right, because if I go ahead and add 3 plus 9, I'm going to get 12 back. So if I had $12 and somebody borrowed $9, I am left with $3. And if I take the amount I'm left with, which is $3, add to that the amount someone borrowed, so if they paid me back, I would have my $12 again. So subtraction and addition are very closely related. In fact, you're going to find that about a lot of mathematical concepts are very closely related. So we're going to use some of the things we learned about addition to check our work in subtraction. Okay? So I could give you some more examples and you can do them. Say, for example, that you wanted to take 20 minus 8. Well, 20 minus 8, you can do that in your head. That's going to give you 12. And you can check this is right, because if I take 12 and add to that 8, I'm going to get 20 back. So we can check subtraction by adding. Okay, let's say we have a little bit a bigger number. Say we wanted to subtract 9,163 minus 142. So again, you should be thinking, which is the minuend, which is the subtrahend? The minuend is 9,163. The subtrahend is 142. And the difference would be the answer when I subtract these two numbers. So very much like I did with adding, I'm just going to line up the numbers based on their place values. So here we have 9,163 minus 142. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go by place value, starting all the way at the ones place, and start subtracting. So when I first subtract 3 minus 2, I'm going to get 1. 6 minus 4 is going to give me 2. 1 minus 1 is 0. And 9 minus nothing, you can just picture a 0 being there, would just be 9. So the difference of 9,163 and 142 is 9,021. Let's try one more just to drive the point home. If I have 978 minus 851 and I want to find their difference again, just going to subtract by place value starting at the ones place. 8 minus 1 would be 7, 7 minus 5 would be 2, and 9 minus 8 would be 1. So my answer is 127. Okay. Just like we started going ahead and carrying over with addition, we're going to start borrowing with subtraction. So let me show you how that works. So let's say that I have the numbers 697 minus the number 49. If I try to subtract 9 from 7, so here's my ones place and I'm subtracting 9 from 7, the problem is the 7 minus 9, that doesn't give me a whole number. I know how to subtract numbers when I have a larger number minus a smaller number, but in this case I have 7 minus 9, so I can't do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and look at the 9 next to it and borrow from that 9. So I am going to make this 9 an 8 and make this 7 a 17. So I borrowed a tens from the tens place, which made my 7 a 17 now. So now I can take 17 minus 9. 17 minus 9, and that would just give me 8. Okay, then I can subtract what I have left over in the tenth place, which is 8 minus 4, that would give me 4. And 6 minus 0 would just be 6. And again, we can check we did this right by going ahead and adding 648 plus 49. 8 plus 9 would give me 17, carry the 1. 1 plus 4 plus 4 would give me 9. And 6 plus 0 would give me 6. So because I ended up back at my menu end, I know my answer is right. Let's try one more of these. I know that you may either be a little bit forgetful of how to subtract by borrowing, or maybe you did this a long time ago. So let's just go ahead and do another example. Let's go ahead and subtract 245 from 326. So let me start at the ones place. 6 minus 5, that's okay. I don't need to borrow there because 6 minus 5 is just 1. 2 minus 4, I do need to borrow there because I don't necessarily know what 2 minus 4 is. So I'm going to borrow from the 3. That 3 is going to become a 2. And my original 2 is going to become a 12. Okay, 12 minus 4 is 8. And 2 minus 2 is 0. So I don't need to write that there because the 0 in the hundredth place is just going to be 0. So my answer is 81. And again, let me get in the habit of checking. So to check, I take my difference plus my subtrahend. And if I did everything right, my answer should be my minuend. I should get back over here to my minuend. So 1 plus 5 is 6. 8 plus 4 is 12. Carry the 1. And then 1 plus 2 is 3. My answer is right.